Today we will start with structures of pelvis or structures in pelvis, in which mainly we will deal with vessels and nerves present in relation with pelvis. In pelvis, major vessels comes here and after that it divides. Which vessels, which nerves comes here and gives its branches? We will see one by one. First, blood vessels in pelvis. Mainly in pelvis, or you can say lateral wall of pelvis or posterior surface aspect of pelvis, vessels enters inside this pelvis. Which blood vessels? Median sacral artery, then superior rectal artery and internal iliac artery. These three vessels present in relation with this pelvis. Now out of this, first, median sacral artery. This median sacral artery, it is a single artery which arises from dorsal aspect of aorta. Then it goes downward. This artery, median sacral artery, arises before branching of this abdominal aorta, and it arises on the dorsal aspect of this abdominal aorta. Then it goes downward, straight downward, and enters inside this cavity of pelvis in relation with its posterior aspect. It lies in relation with this central aspect of sacrum and coccyx, or you can say median part or central part of this sacrum, present in relation with posterior aspect of pelvis. Now this artery, it is a single. As it goes downward, it gives some branches to rectum in relation with this posterior aspect. Also, it gives some small branches to this, or which enters inside this pelvic sacral foramen. But these are very small branches. Then it gives out some small muscular branches also. This one is median sacral artery, as it is a single. Then second branch is superior rectal artery. Now this superior rectal artery, again it is a single branch which is present in relation with posterior aspect of this pelvis on its left side. It is a branch of inferior mesenteric artery, or you can say terminal branch of this inferior mesenteric artery. Now this superior rectal artery enters inside this in relation with lateral aspect of this ala of sacrum. Then it goes downward in relation with this posterior aspect of this rectum. Then it divides into two branches which will go laterally. As it is in relation with rectum and name indicates superior rectal artery, therefore it will supply. This is upper part of this rectum. Also some structures in relation with posterior aspect of this rectum. This is again single branch, single artery in pelvis, superior rectal artery. Now paired arteries. Which paired arteries? Internal iliac artery. These are two in number, present on left and right side of this in relation with mainly lateral wall of pelvis. Now in relation with this lateral wall of pelvis, this internal iliac artery present, and this internal iliac artery, it is a branch coming from common iliac artery. This common iliac artery divides into two branches, internal iliac and external iliac artery. Now we'll see internal iliac artery, its course and its branches. This internal iliac artery, it is a branch coming from common iliac artery. Now you know this. Then this artery comes in relation with, or comes down in relation with, margin of greater sciatic foramen. And in relation with this foramen, it will divides into two branches. anterior and posterior, or can say anterior division and posterior division of internal iliac artery. This anterior and posterior division now supply structures present in this pelvis with the help of its branches. Which branches coming from this anterior division? This first, this anterior division goes downward in relation with anterior margin of this greater sciatic notch, and it will go toward this ischial spine, inner surface of this ischial spine. Now during its course, this artery gives out its branches. This internal iliac artery, which division? Anterior division. Now in relation with this anterior division, it will give out branches. First, branches coming from this anterior division of internal iliac artery. First branch is obliterated umbilical artery. Now these branches, first I will tell you branches in relation with male pelvis. But there is a slight or minor difference in relation with branching pattern in female. Which branches present in male? In relation with lateral wall of pelvis from anterior division, obliterated umbilical artery, superior vesical artery, inferior vesical artery, then middle rectal artery, obturator artery, and inferior gluteal artery and internal pudendal artery. Now these branches are present in male, but in female there is a minor difference. Two arteries, uterine artery and vaginal artery, these are additionally present, or minor change in vessels, and it will form vessels of this female, or branches coming from anterior division of internal iliac artery in female. Therefore, there is a minor difference in branching pattern coming from anterior division of this internal iliac artery in female. In male, obliterated umbilical artery, superior and inferior vesical artery, middle rectal artery, then obturator artery, inferior gluteal artery, and internal pudendal artery. In female, additional branches, uterine and vaginal artery. We'll see all these branches one by one. Now it is location of this internal iliac artery in relation with lateral pelvic wall. As you can see here, just I want to add something in relation with this artery, which structures lies in relation with this internal iliac artery. In relation with this artery, on lateral aspect of this internal iliac artery, you can see here there is presence of obturator. Now then external iliac vein, and medially there is presence of parietal peritoneum covering this internal iliac artery. And in relation with this parietal peritoneum, on right side there is presence of terminal part of ileum, and on left side there is presence of sigmoid column. Medially, lateral relation, medial relation. Now anterior to this internal iliac artery, there is presence of ovarian fossa in female, and in relation with upper part there is presence of ureter, pelvic part of ureter. This is in relation with anterior part of this internal iliac artery. Now posterior to this internal iliac artery, there is presence of sacroiliac joint, lumbosacral trunk on both sides. Now these are relations of internal iliac artery. Now again back to this branches of internal iliac artery. Branches coming from where? In relation with this, or branches coming from anterior division of this internal iliac artery. First, obliterated umbilical artery. Now you can see here there is presence of this both branches of this coming from this anterior and posterior division. First we'll see here branches coming from this anterior division. Uppermost is obliterated umbilical artery. Now this is part of this umbilical artery. terminal part of umbilical artery during intrauterine life, which carries deoxygenated blood, and this terminal part degenerates, and in adult it will form obliterated part of this umbilical artery. Now proximal part of this umbilical artery persists as superior vesical artery. As name indicates, vesicle, this superior vesical artery will supply upper urinary bladder, then terminal part of ureter, and structures in relation with this upper aspect of this urinary bladder. Now, second branch, inferior vesical artery. Now, this inferior vesical artery, it is the next branch of this anterior division of interiliac artery. Now, this inferior vesical artery here goes towards lower part of this, or you can say base of this urinary bladder. As name indicates, vesicle means urinary bladder. Therefore, it will supply this base of urinary bladder, lower part of ureters, seminal vesicles, and vas deferens in male. In female, inferior vesical artery, it is replaced by vaginal artery. As I already said that there is minor difference in vessels of the coming from this anterior division. Therefore, inferior vesical artery in female, it is replaced by vaginal artery. But in male, inferior vesical artery is present. Now this inferior vesical artery. After that, next one is middle rectal artery. Now this middle rectal artery, it may arise as a separate branch or along with inferior vesical artery. Now this middle rectal artery, it, as name indicates, it will go towards this rectum and it will supply this middle part of this rectum. Next artery. Now in relation with this, there is presence of one obturator artery. This obturator artery, you can see here, this is a, it is going straight forward, and now it is in present in relation with lateral wall of pelvis, and it will go towards this obturator canal. This obturator artery go anteriorly in relation with this obturator canal, or you can say upper margin of this obturator internus muscle, and this obturator artery goes out through this obturator canal. In perineum or in pelvis, it will give out very small branches which will supply part of urethra, then some small perineal branches which will supply minor structure present in this pelvis. Now this is obturator artery. After that, there is presence of inferior gluteal artery and internal pudendal artery. Later on I will cover uterine artery and vaginal artery in female. Inferior gluteal artery. Now this inferior gluteal artery, it will go posteriorly and backward. As it goes posteriorly and backward, it will pass in between S1 and S2 nerves, roots of this S1 and S2 nerves, sacral 1 and sacral 2 nerves. It will go backward and posteriorly. Now this artery, as name indicates, it will supply gluteal muscles after its exit through this, after its exit from this pelvis. Now this is inferior gluteal artery. Next one. Now this next one is internal pudendal artery. Now this internal pudendal artery, it is a terminal branch of this anterior division of internal iliac artery. Now this internal pudendal artery, it goes out of this pelvis through greater sciatic foramen and again enters inside this perineal canal in relation with lateral wall of this ischio rectal fossa and it passes through this pudendal canal or Alcox canal. Now it enters in relation with perineal pouches, and in relation with this superficial and the perineal pouches, it will use branches which will supply structures present in superficial and deep perineal pouches. Now this internal pudendal artery, again it will give small branches to bulb of penis or dorsal artery of penis. Now these two terminal branches, artery to the bulb of penis and dorsal artery of penis, in female, instead of this artery to the bulb of penis, there is presence of artery to the vestibule of vagina. This is branches coming from this internal pudendal. Now other branches coming from this internal pudendal artery, we already covered deep artery of penis, dorsal artery of penis. These are two terminal branches coming from this internal pudendal artery. Also it will give inferior rectal artery, one perineal branch, artery to the bulb of penis, and one separate urethral branch. Inferior rectal artery, it will go toward this lower aspect of rectum and it will supply the structure, lower part of rectum and perianal region. Then perineal branches coming from this internal pudendal artery, it will supply structure present in the superficial perineal branches, superficial perineal pouch. Now artery to the bulb of penis, it will go towards this bulb of penis and it will supply corpus spongiosum of penis in male. Now in female, it will supply this vestibular branch to this erectile tissues of vagina. Now urethral branch, this urethral branch goes anteriorly toward this glans penis and it will supply complete spongy urethra. And two terminal branches, deep artery of penis and dorsal artery of penis. Deep artery of penis passes deep to this penis and it will supply tissues present in corpus cavernosum of penis. Again, branches to vestibule of vagina in female. Dorsal artery of penis, it is present, it passes anteriorly after penetrating perineal membranes. Branches, all branches which comes out of this perineum or pelvis, it will penetrate this perineal membrane. After penetrating this perineal membrane, it will comes out through small gap. This dorsal artery of penis, it will comes out through small gap present in between arcuate pubic ligament and transverse perineal ligament. And it will supply, it is present, dorsal artery of penis present in relation with dorsal surface of penis and it will supply dorsal aspect of penis. Now these are branches coming from internal pudendal arteries. In female, as already mentioned, there is presence of uterine artery and vaginal artery. Vaginal artery in female, it is a branch. In female, inferior vesical artery is replaced by vaginal artery. Now this vaginal artery, it will go towards vagina and it will form plexus or network in relation with anterior and posterior wall of vagina. And this plexus or network in relation with anterior and posterior wall of vagina, it will supply this vaginal walls, this vaginal artery. This vaginal artery also supply structure anterior to this vagina. Therefore, it will supply part of this urinary bladder. It will also supply rectum. Now, uterine artery. Uterine artery, this uterine female, it is a large branch coming from this anterior division of internal iliac artery. First, it lies lateral to pelvic part of ureter. Now, it crosses this pelvic part of ureter from lateral to medial side near this lower part of this uterus, or you can say near cervix. This uterine artery crosses this ureter from lateral to medial aspect. Then it will enter inside this lower attached margin of this broad ligament of uterus. This uterine artery goes upwards in snake like manner. It will show tortuosity, and it will go upward near to lateral margin of this uterus. It will go toward this uterine tube. Now this uterine artery present in relation with lateral margin of the uterus inside this broad ligament of uterus. It will go toward this uterine tube. It will also passes just below this uterine tube. It will passes also, but it will use small branch which pass through this mesh ovarium, and it will go towards ovary, and it will anastomose with ovarian artery. Therefore, during its course, this uterine artery will supply upper part of vagina, uterus, ovary, uterine tube. It will also give branches to this urinary bladder and part of this ureter. Now these are branches coming from this anterior division of internal iliac artery. Now next, branches coming from posterior division of this internal iliac artery. Now these are iliolumbar artery, superior gluteal artery and lateral sacral artery. First, iliolumbar branch coming from this posterior division. Iliolumbar artery, it is a first branch coming from this posterior division of internal iliac artery. It will go upward in relation with this anterior aspect of this piriformis muscle. It passes through this lumbosacral in between. It passes in between lumbosacral trunk and obturator nerve. It will go upward and it will use two branches, iliac branch and lumbar branch. This iliac branch goes or enters inside this iliacus muscle and psoas major muscle. And inside the substance of this iliacus, it will supply these muscles. Also here, it will use a nutritive branch or branch to this iliac bone. Now this is iliac branch. Now second one is lumbar branch. Lumbar branch will go upward through the substance of this psoas major muscle, and it will join one artery, fourth lumbar artery, coming from upward. Then it will supply this muscle. Then it will use one branch which will enter through this intervertebral foramen in between fifth lumbar and first sacral vertebra, and it will supply this, passes through this foramen and goes inside this vertebral canal. This is iliolumbar artery. Second one is superior gluteal artery. Superior gluteal artery passes laterally and backward. It goes out through this greater sciatic foramen to this gluteal region to supply muscles of this gluteal region. Now, next one is lateral sacral. Lateral sacral branch goes laterally. Mainly, it divides into two branches, upper and lower. This lateral sacral artery comes in relation with this lateral part of ala of sacrum, then goes downward in relation with lateral margin of pelvic sacral foramina. Through this foramina, now upper and lower branches enters inside this vertebral canal through this pelvic sacral foramina. Therefore, there are branches which will supply this vertebral canal or which enters through this pelvic sacral foramina. After its entry, some branches comes out to this dorsal sacral foramina also for its supply. Means iliolumbar artery, lateral sacral artery and superior gluteal artery. Now one point to note here, that superior gluteal artery, when it passes laterally and backward, it will pass through this lumbosacral trunk and first sacral nerve S1 during its lateral course. Now this is about vessels, arteries in relation with this wall of pelvis. Now some nerves in relation with this wall of pelvis. Nerves, which nerve present here? Somatic and autonomic. In somatic nerves, first is obturator nerve, then sacral plexus and coccygeal plexus. Obturator nerve, it comes here in pelvis in relation with lateral wall of pelvis. Now you know branches coming from this common iliac artery, internal and external iliac artery. And this obturator now runs in relation with lateral wall of pelvis, in relation with upper margin of this attached part of this obturator internus muscle, passes through this obturator canal along with this vessels and nerves. It is a branch. Obturator nerve is a branch coming from lumbar plexus. How it forms? It forms in the substance of psoas major muscle. And these nerves forms from branches coming from this L2, L3 and L4. L2, L3 and L4, lumbar 2nd, 3rd and 4th. These three joins in the substance of the psoas major. Then after formation of obturator nerve, this nerve comes downward and in relation with medial margin of psoas major, then it crosses this ala of sacrum and goes anteriorly and in relation with lateral wall of pelvis deep to internal iliac artery and vessels and goes anteriorly and passes through this obturator canal along with vessels. Then it will go out through this obturator canal outside. This is about obturator nerve. Now this obturator nerve, during its course in pelvis, it will give minimum branches. It will give some branches to this sacroiliac joint and some small perineal branches. But here in relation with this obturator nerve, there is no major supply here inside this pelvis. It will also give out some branches to this part of urethra and ureter also. Now, sacral plexus. In sacral plexus, there is formation of the sacral plexus in relation with anterior aspect of piriformis muscle. How it forms? Now this in relation with this anterior aspect of piriformis, it forms from L4, L5 and upper four sacral nerves, S1, S2, S3 and S4. Roots coming from S1, S2, S3 and S4 and ventral rami, 4th and 5th lumbar nerves. All these will form sacral plexus. You can see here. Now these sacral plexus gives out branches. Which branches? Coming from this sacral plexus. These branches coming from this sacral plexus are in pelvis and outside pelvis. Branches coming from this sacral plexus are branches present inside pelvis and branches which will go out of pelvis to supply lower limb and gluteal region. First, we'll see branches present inside pelvis. Now, in relation with pelvis, branches first, or you can say in pelvis, it will give 5 branches mainly in pelvis. Which branches? Now to piriformis, now to levator, ana and coccygeus, then perineal branch of S4, pelvic splanchnic nerve and pudendal nerve. Which 5 branches? Now to piriformis, now to levator, ana and coccygeus, perineal branch of S4, pelvic splanchnic nerve and pudendal nerve. Now upper nerves mainly coming from these roots of sacral nerves directly. Now to piriformis. We will see one by one all these nerves. Now to piriformis, it forms in the substance of this piriformis from coming from S1 and S2. Roots coming from S1 and S2. And then it will supply this piriformis muscle inside this muscle after its formation. This is nerve to piriformis. Then second one is nerve to levator ana and coccygeus. Again, it will form in the substance of piriformis. Branches coming from roots of S3 and S4, sacral 3rd and 4th. After its formation, it will go laterally and downward. and it will supply. After its downward course, it will go medially to supply levator and coccygeus. These are branches coming from roots of sacral nerves. Now one branch, perineal branch of S4. This is a small branch coming from S4 root. This branch coming from S4 root, it will go downward and it will supply sphincter ani externus. It will also give out one small branch which will supply skin around this perianal region. The next one is pelvic splanchnic nerve. It forms by joining S2, S3 and S4 roots. These nerves, after joining pelvic splanchnic nerve, it mainly carries parasympathetic fibers. As it carries mainly parasympathetic fibers, it carries motor fibers and viscerosensory fibers. These pelvic splanchnic nerves goes downward anteriorly toward this wall of rectum. Here it will form hypogastric plexus. Now this hypogastric plexus, in relation with wall of this rectum, it will give preganglionic fibers of this parasympathetic nerve supply. Now postganglionic fibers are related in relation with this wall of viscera present in this pelvis. Now this postganglionic fibers, ganglion present in this wall of viscera, it will supply all viscera present in pelvis like uterus, urinary bladder, rectum. And this, main, as it carries mainly parasympathetic fibers, therefore it is responsible for peristalsis and relaxation of sphincter of anus. And in relation with this urinary bladder, it is responsible for filling of bladder and evacuation of bladder. One nerve also supply to this uterus, and it is responsible for carrying pain sensations, and it will decrease contraction of myometrium of uterus. Then it gives one nervi irrigans. Nervi irrigans, these are branches which are going toward these erectile tissues of penis and vagina. And these, mainly penis, it is responsible for erection of penis. Therefore, name is nervi irrigans, coming from pelvic splanchnic nerves. Now, this parasympathetic supply responsible for erection of penis, but for ejaculation, sympathetic nerve supply is responsible. Now, next branch is pudendal nerve. How it forms? Now, again, it is in pelvis. And as pudendal nerve, it runs along with internal pudendal vessels. Pudendal nerve forms here now from nerves coming from ventral division of sacral 2nd, 3rd and 4th, S2, S3 and S4. Ventral division of this S2, S3 and S4. Now in relation with this pudendal nerve, S2, S3 and S4, it goes downward laterally in relation with this lateral wall of pelvis. Then it passes, it goes out to this greater sciatic foramen. Then it will give out its branches. Now during its course, it will give out branches. Which branch? Inferior rectal branch, perineal branch, and some small branches to this lower part of this pelvis. Now which branches? First, from this pudendal nerve, it gives inferior rectal branch, which will supply this inferior or lower part of rectum and anal canal up to pectoral. Also, it will supply this perianal skin. Then its perineal branches. Now these perineal branches, it is divided into two parts, superficial and deep part. Now this superficial branch and deep branch coming from this perineal branch of this pudendal nerve. Deep branch, after its entry in pelvis, or can say in relation with this superficial and deep peroneal pouch, it will use mainly muscular branches to muscles present in relation with this superficial and deep peroneal pouches. Which muscles? Bulbous spongiosus, ischiocavernosus, superficial and deep transverse perineae, and sphincter urethra. This is now subclavian is deep branch of this peroneal branch coming from pudendal nerve. Now superficial branch, it will also supply this superficial or upper aspect or area in relation with this lower part of this anal canal or in relation with this fossils. Now this is about nerve supply of this pudendal nerve. Now all these branches, five branches present in pelvis. Now which branches goes out of this pelvis and which will supply this part of gluteal region and lower limb? Now there are near about seven branches in relation with this. All these branches comes out of this greater sciatic foramen and it will lie above or below this piriformis muscle. Now first, superior gluteal nerve. This is a branch which will go in relation with upper aspect of this piriformis muscle. How it forms? It forms by dorsal branches of ventral rami, of which L4, L5, S1. Dorsal branches of ventral rami L4, 5, S1. Now this superior gluteal nerve, after its exit from this pelvis, it will supply gluteus minimus and medius. Now remaining branches are inferior gluteal nerve, nerve to quadratus femoris, nerve to obturator internus, posterior femoral cutaneous nerve, perforating cutaneous nerve, and sciatic nerve. First is superior gluteal nerve, which lies above piriformis. Now second, inferior gluteal nerve. How it forms? Now this inferior gluteal nerve, it forms by dorsal branches of ventral rami of L5, S1, S2. L5, S1, S2. But coming from dorsal branches of ventral rami. After its exit, it lies below this piriformis muscle and it will supply gluteus maximus muscle. Then other nerve. Third, nerve to quadratus femoris. Now this nerve, it again lies below this piriformis. After its exit, so this greater sciatic foramen, it will supply, during its course, it will supply quadratus femoris muscle and inferior gemelli muscle. This is one additional nerve supply from this nerve to quadratus femoris. How it forms? It forms by ventral branches of ventral rami of L4, L5, S1. This is nerve to quadratus femoris. Now fourth, nerve to obturator internus. After its exit, there is again re-entry of this nerve to obturator internus to supply this obturator internus muscle. And how it forms? This nerve forms by ventral branches of ventral rami of L5, S1 and S2. During its course, it supplies obturator internus, also gemellus superior muscle. Now fifth one, posterior femoral cutaneous nerve. Its root value is S1, S2, S3. But how it forms S1, S2, S3? It forms by dorsal branches coming from S1 and S2 and ventral branches of ventral rami coming from S2, S3. Therefore, S1, S2, S3. But dorsal branches of ventral rami coming from S1 and S2 and ventral branches of ventral rami coming from S2, S3. It goes downwards after its exit in relation with lower margin of piriformis. And this posterior femoral cutaneous nerve, it will supply lower part of this gluteal region, back of thigh and leg up to its middle part. Now perforating cutaneous nerve, this one is sixth nerve. Now this perforating cutaneous nerve, how it forms? It is formed by dorsal branches of ventral rami of S2 and S3. Now this perforating cutaneous nerve is a small branch. It will penetrate sacrotuberous ligament and it will supply lower part of this gluteal region. Now last one, seventh branch. Sciatic nerve. It is a large terminal branch of coming from this sacral plexus. And this sciatic nerve, it shows two components, common peroneal component and tibial component. How it forms? Tibial component having different root value and common peroneal component is having different value, root value. Now this tibial component, it comes from ventral branches of ventral rami of L4, L5 as 1, 2, 3. But common peroneal component, it comes from dorsal branches of ventral rami of L4, L5, S1, 2. Tibial component comes from ventral branches of this nerve and common peroneal component comes from this dorsal branches of ventral rami. Now, this total nerve, root value, L4, 5, S1, 2, 3. This, it will go downward in relation with this lower margin of piriformis, in relation with posterior aspect of thigh. During its course, it will supply semimembranosus, semitendinosus, long head of biceps femoris, and ischial head of adductor magnus. This is about total 7 nerves coming from sacral plexus outside pelvis to lower limb. But inside pelvis, 5 branches. Inside pelvis, 5 branches. Outside pelvis, 7 branches. This is about nerve supply coming from this sacral plexus. Now just, we have already mentioned that there is presence of coccygeal plexus. Now this coccygeal plexus lies in relation with coccygeus muscle. How it forms? It is formed by S5 and coccygeal 1. Now, this coccygeal branches coming from this coccygeal nerve, it will give small branches which will supply cutaneous area or skin in relation with outer aspect of this anus, perianal area. Now, this is only one single small branch coming from this coccygeal plexus. Here, in addition to this artery, now, I want to add veins also here. In relation with this, inside this pelvis, there is presence of veins also, which somatic veins and visceral veins. With these somatic veins, mainly internal iliac vein. Now, internal iliac vein joins with external iliac vein, it will drain into common iliac. Here, these branches or you can say tributaries of this internal iliac vein are same as branches of this internal iliac artery. Names are same, except umbilical artery and iliolumbar artery. These two branches not correspond with the tributaries of this internal iliac vein. Therefore, tributaries of this internal iliac vein are same as branches of internal iliac artery, except two. Now, this is about somatic veins. Visceral veins. Visceral veins present in relation with this viscera present in pelvis. Which viscera? Urinary bladder, prostate, vagina. All these. There is formation of plexus or network of veins in relation with these organs. Prostatic plexus, vesical plexus, all these plexus, vaginal plexus, form in relation with this wall of this viscera, and these plexus now form a single vein which will drain into internal iliac veins. During its course, what happens? These veins goes backward with the help of this posterior ligament of urinary bladder. As it passes backward to drain into internal iliac vein, some veins also enters inside this vertebral canal and it will drains into or it will joins with internal vertebral venous plexus. Therefore, sometimes there is possibility of spread of any infectious material or metastasis of cancer with the help of these veins inside this vertebral canal with the help of these joining veins. This is all about structures, mainly vessels, artery, veins and nerves present in pelvis. Thank you.